Part two now of our interview with the candidates for Indio District 1.
Okay, last question. What makes you a better candidate than your opponent? Glenn.
Well, experience, proven results, proven leadership. I've got a great relationship. I'm the chairman of the CVAG Executive Committee. I'm also the vice chair of the Sunline Bus. You become these, with you get experience working with your fellow cities, your tribal leaders, your other agencies, and that's what it comes to the table when you get with me. When you look at what I've been able to accomplish along with the rest of the leaders of this community, along with the leaders of the Coachella Valley, since I've been on council, not only have we expanded the opportunities here in the city of Indio, and we are bringing youth programs into the city of Indio. We are working on all the things that Ms. Turan is talking about. You just got to look deeper to see what's going on with COVID-19. It's affected a lot of the stuff we've done. Proven leadership, keeping our businesses open. And at the same time, the city of Indio is bringing in all kinds of new businesses, new jobs and opportunities. Where other cities are making cuts and cutting back, the city of Indio is continuing to move forward, and that takes leadership. One of the opportunities we had was just recently when we had the fire and three individuals' homes lost their trailers and mobile homes from the fire. Chairman Daryl Mike, who's a friend of mine, came forward, worked with us, has worked with the city of Indio, brought forward a plan to be able to purchase those. That comes with experience, that comes with working together, and that comes with relationships. So proven leadership, proven relationships, that's what comes to the table. And the experience that I bring is exactly what the city of Indio needs right now, a steady hand to continue with our finances, continue to keep our businesses open safely and efficiently, and at the same time, bring in new businesses and programs for our residents and our community.
Aaron.
Well, Mayor Miller wants you to believe that I have a lack of experience. And I'll tell you, as a nurse, I oversee a fiscally conservative budget daily. I also help patients with resources, such as the homeless patients that I work with on a daily basis at the mental health hospital. I've served on the front lines for the COVID pandemic, and I understand the issues that our city's facing. What we need now is to bring our community together. We have so much divisiveness, and we really need to bring some unity to our city. It's going to be so important for people to recognize that we're all going through the same issues. While we may have different experiences, we have so much that's the same. We're worried about our families. We're worried about keeping them safe. We're worried about putting food on the table. We want our local businesses to succeed. But the best thing that we can do right now to overcome those issues is really to work together to improve our beautiful city of Indio.
All right. Aaron and Glenn, we appreciate your time. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Aaron.
Thank you, Mayor Miller. Thank you, Peter.
On Tuesday, we'll hear from the three candidates running for Indio's 5th district.